How can I integrate Oracle Sales Cloud and NetSuite to synchronize account creation quickly? Oracle Integration Cloud Service, or ICS, enables me to integrate Oracle Sales Cloud and NetSuite and synchronize account creation in real time, efficiently, and without coding. In order to configure an integration, I complete a series of steps in Oracle Integration Cloud Service. Create source connection. Create target connection. Create integration. Configure data mapping. Configure data tracking. Save and activate the integration. And monitor integration for new messages. I use Oracle Integration Cloud Service to integrate Oracle Sales Cloud and NetSuite. On the home page, I can create connections and integrations. I can also monitor active integrations. I start by creating the target connection using the NetSuite adapter. I enter the connection details. A unique connection identifier is generated automatically. I configure the NetSuite connection by providing the WSDL URL. Because it's password protected, I also provide security details. Once the NetSuite connection is configured, I verify its connectivity. The NetSuite connection is marked as configured. It's ready to be used in my integration. On the Connections page, I create the source connection to my Oracle Sales Cloud instance using the Oracle Sales Cloud adapter. I enter the connection details. Just as before, a unique connection identifier is generated automatically. To configure the Oracle Sales Cloud connection, I provide the WSDL URL for the OSC service catalog and the username and password. I verify its connectivity. The Oracle Sales Cloud connection is marked as configured. It's ready to be added to my integration. On the home page, I continue to create the integration using the configured Oracle Sales Cloud and NetSuite connections. I'm creating an integration to synchronize account creation between Oracle Sales Cloud and NetSuite. When a new account gets created in Oracle Sales Cloud, the same will happen in NetSuite. There are three supported types of integrations. I select the Map My Data option because it enables one-to-one application interaction. I provide the integration details like name and identifier. A package name can be provided so that related integrations can be grouped together to simplify management. The version number is automatically generated. The integration canvas lists all the available configured connections. I set the Oracle Sales Cloud connection as the source and provide additional information for the source connection. I provide the requested information while adding the source connection. I need to synchronize account creation so I configure the business object that'll be sent from Oracle Sales Cloud in the request. I verify the selection. The account object should be selected in both the request and the response. The Oracle Sales Cloud connection appears as the source in the integration canvas. Next, I continue configuring the target using the configured NetSuite connection. I provide basic information for the target connection, including the endpoint name and a description. I select the target object and the applied operation at the NetSuite instance endpoint. On the summary page, I verify that the settings are correct before completing target connection configuration. The integration canvas displays source and target connections. Next, I proceed with the data mapping between source and target connections for my integration. This is a crucial part of the integration configuration. I start by creating the upstream mapping that's the one from source to target connections. For some integrations, depending on the source and target connections combination, Oracle Integration Service offers Oracle and customer recommendations, inference based on structure of messages, and mapping based on name matching. In this case, I manually map my data. I configure the target to source connection data mapping. For this example, I'll configure the mapping manually, but there's always the option of uploading a data mapping configuration file. Upon response, the source account name needs to be updated with the NetSuite account organization name. This mapping does that. Once the data mapping is complete, I configure data tracking for monitoring. This enables me to select what data is available when monitoring messages in Oracle Integration Cloud Service. I select the fields I want to use to track messages. I'll monitor account's organization name. Before activating the integration, I save it. When I activate the integration, I'm offered the option of enabling detailed tracing that can be used when developing and debugging. On the monitor page, I can review the integration's general statistics. At the bottom, the details for each integration are displayed, including total messages and errors per integration. I've successfully configured the integration between Oracle Sales Cloud and NetSuite using Oracle Integration Service. For more information on Oracle Cloud, visit cloud.oracle.com/integration. Thank you for watching.